What you're about to see is the pride of India, built 1,000 years ago, which is certainly the greatest, the grandest, the glorious, and the largest temple of India, which cannot be even dreamt of rebuilding. Presenting a documentary on Tanjavur Big Temple.
நஞ்சை கழனிகளின் நாயகனே நீ வாழ்க, நடனமிடும் காவேரி காவலனே நீ வாழ்க,
தஞ்சமென வருவோர்க்கு தஞ்சம் வழங்குகின்ற தஞ்சை பெருவுடைய தலைவனே நீ வாழ்க,
பெஞ்சமரில் வெற்றி கண்டு அஞ்சலிக்கும் மக்களுக்கோர் பின்னுயர் பெரிய கோயில் தந்த தஞ்சை பெரிய கோயில் பல்லாண்டு வாழவே, தஞ்சை பெரிய கோயில் பல்லாண்டு வாழவே, தஞ்சை பெரிய கோயில் பல்லாண்டு வாழவே, தாரணியில் தமிழ் போல நிலை நின்று வாழவே, தாரணியில் தமிழ் போல நிலை நின்று வாழவே, தஞ்சை பெரிய கோயில் பல்லாண்டு வாழவே.
தஞ்சாவூர் பிக் டெம்பிள், ஆல்சோ நோன் அஸ் பிரஹதீஸ்வரா டெம்பிள் or the Peruvudaiyar Kovil, was constructed by the Emperor Arulmuli Varman, popularly known as Rajarajeswara I, in the year 1010 AD. Kunjaramallan Rajaraja Perundachan was the architect of the temple. In the year 1987, the temple was declared as the World Heritage Monument. The entire temple is made out of granite. The temple is made up of 130 tons of granite. The Vimana, or the temple tower, is 216 feet high and is among the tallest of its kind in the world. The Kumbham of the temple is carved out of 8 stones and it weighs around 80 tons. The temple is maintained by the Archaeological Survey of India, and one must say it is one of the most well-maintained temple in our country.
Brihadeshwara Temple, the World Heritage Monument, is located in Tanjore. It's called Rajarajeswaram. That is Tanjore, Tamil Nadu, constructed by Rajarajeswara, the great Chola king. Built in the year 985 to 1010 AD. It is also known as the Big Temple or Dakshinameru. Dakshinameru in a sense, it is comparing this with the Himalayas because of that Vimana. It is three entrances as you must be seeing it. First entrance is called as Rajarajan Thiruvalli, that is Rajarajan's time it is there. And it is renovated during the Nayak period, but it is also inscription references are there. And the voluminous inscriptions are there. And next is second entrance is Keralantharam, it's called the nomenclatures. And the third is arch like this Maratha. The main challenging is conservation. The conservation norms for Atlas Survey of India, we have to maintain the originality without adding additions or deletions. That's the main important aspect of our conservation. And we should not just replace anything new. There are other ways to use this authenticity.
The Brihadeshwara Temple, built by King Rajarajeswara, is known for its architectural beauty. More than 1,000 years old, the main importance of this temple is the shadow of the main tower will not fall underground. I enjoy the surrounding beauty and calmness of this area. I visit this temple regularly for meditation.
The temple is also well known for the sculptures on its walls, and all of them were chiseled out of stone. All of them were finished off with a thin coat of lime plaster. Iconically and aesthetically, they blend with the architectural style of the temple. The Dwarapalas are four armed, which are more than the life-size images, can be found in the Gopura, in the Mukha Mandapa, in the Maha Mandapa, and in the outer walls of Ardha Mandapa passage.
Who introduced such a type in Tamil Nadu? I told the Pallavas have introduced and the Cholas improved this structure, and they have for the first time they have raised this sky high Vimana. And I have told you the pyramidal structure that is just above, just over the Garbhagraha is called Vimana, and the pyramidal structure that you can see at the entry point is Gopura. And I have made a difference between the Cholas and the Pandyas. The Cholas, they have adopted the style of constructing the Vimana sky high, and the Pandyas on the contrary, they have introduced the construction of raising the Gopura, sky high Gopuras. That is the difference I have told.
The sacred bull, popularly known as the Nandi, is a monolithic sculpture made out of a single black stone. The Nandi was believed to be the Vagana or the vehicle of Lord Shiva, and also it was believed that if Lord Shiva was seated on the bull with his wife Parvati on his side, he was called as Rishabhantika.
Tanjore was ruled by three dynasties, first Chola, then Naik, then Maratha. Maratha came to Tanjore on 16th century. At that time, the queens and kings contributed a lot for the temples. Particularly, big temple was renovated in Maratha period also. The big temple, one of the temples maintained by Maratha royal family. Palace Devastanam was established after the at the time of British government. We are the hereditary trustee of this Palace Devastanam.
Has Chola murals on the walls made out of frescoes portraying Shiva in action. The Chola artists portrayed the Asura women with a sense of beauty. The Archaeological Survey of India mounted all these paintings on fiberglass boards displayed at a separate pavilion. This is the most famous painting of Rajaraja Chola I with his mentor Karvur Devar. During the Hindu auspicious season of Margali in the month of December, special puja and darshan takes place even in the late evenings and in the early mornings. Yeah. Devotee Saktivel says, there are many temples in Tamil Nadu, but this is one such temple which is known for its legacy of 1000 years. I have noticed many temples being painted with bright colors, but this is one such temple where the original color still exists. The Nandi over here is the famous landmark of the temple, and I've never seen such a huge Nandi ever in my life. Also, this is the largest temple of the country, and I'm experiencing it for the first time in my life.
Being a traveler and heritage enthusiast, I visited many world heritage sites in India. And particularly, I frequently visit Tanjavur Big Temple because of its one of the finest architectural marvels of Dravidian era. I personally feel the Rajaraja Chola's choice and his influence of this sculpture and the design. International tourists are more attracted to Tanjavur Big Temple because of its grandness, its greatness, and its most prized archaeological sites in India.
Vanakkam. My name is Irma Valencia. I'm from San Francisco, California, and we are traveling in southern India, and this temple is just amazing. We understand it's made from granite, and it's a very special, auspicious month because it's the pilgrimage month, and we were able to see the dances this morning. The dancers were beautiful, and before that, they did the blessings. So we are so fortunate to be here for this time period, and actually, we have to tell you that the people of southern India are just friendly, wonderful, and all I can say for having such a beautiful, incredible India and incredible country, Nandi.
Millennium Year celebrations was held in the same complex in a very grand manner in September 2010. I believe this temple will live forever and it will see many number of such Millennium Year celebrations.
On September 25, 2010, the temple had its Millennium Year celebration in a huge manner. A grand dance spectacle of 1000 Bharatanatyam dancers dancing together in unison at the temple as a mark of celebration. Tanjavur Big Temple is the pride of Chola kings, the pride of Tamil culture, the pride of India. This temple does not belong to either one race or one culture or one nation, but it belongs to the entire human race, and that's why it is a World Heritage Monument. Every one of us has to protect, preserve, and propagate the heritage of Tanjavur Big Temple. Tanjai Periya Koyil, Pallandu Valga.